Let's go to Rick James and Tina Marie. Let's see. I'm going to get the lyrics up so we can live the lyrics together, okay? Yep. Boy, there's nobody like Tina Marie. Oh, my gosh. And Rick and Tina together. Oh, my gosh. Their duets were outstanding, including this one. All right. So we'll play it in a moment. Oh, we got to live the lyrics. Hopefully you can see them. I don't even know. If you can't, Google happy lyrics, Rick, Tina. And Rick starts the song. He says, lady, you say this, you can say this to me, and then I'll say the Tina part to you. Says, lady, I can understand your problems and your worries when you love a man like me. And if you don't mind, because the way he's saying it is like he has trouble expressing himself about love also, right? So he's going to say, I love you in this song now. Listen to this melody. And he says, you belong to me. I belong to you. Yes, I do. And we belong to each other, lady. Listen to me, baby. And then he says, there'll be times when I'll be down and I'll be troubled. You see, that's the thing. People think that if they're down or they're troubled, that they shouldn't have someone in their life, or they shouldn't invite someone in their life because it will make the other person's life not so great. Of course, circumstances depending, but in most cases, having someone could also make your life better, right? Having the right one can make your life better. So he says, there'll be times when I'll be down and I'll be troubled trying to be that rising star. This is Rick James. This could be you, right? And he says, but don't worry. And this is so important not to do, right? I will never in our lifetime bust your bubble, he says, or bring you down from where you are. And then he says, he's building her up, you're a queen to me. And Lord knows I'm a king to you. Yeah, and we belong to each other, baby. Yeah, you go to my head. You're a part of everything I say and do. You go to my head and you keep me happy. And look, keep me happy. Because happiness, we did this on one of our resources long ago on how we flooded ATV. Happiness is an inside job, right? It's like there was a little like a screenshot going around of a thing that was like two stick figures or whatever. And one was holding a jar and the label of the jar said happiness. And the other one saw the one with the jar of happiness and said, oh my gosh, I've been looking for that everywhere. Where did you find it? And I think it says, I made it myself. You make your own happiness first. And if you're already happy, even if everything's not perfect, you can still be happy. You're happy that you're happy, not because things are perfect. It's a mindset, right? So no, everything's not perfect in my life, but I'm still happy. I still have joy. And having that happy feelings in the air. If you're having a happy feeling, things won't get you as down as they will if you don't internalize the happiness, if you don't create that happiness from within yourself. Don't count on other people to make you happy. Happiness, again, is an inside job. So he said, yeah, you go to my head. You're part of everything I say and do. Is your person that you're loving and in love with a part of everything you say and do? You just can't get them out of your mind. Everything you think, it's them. I know that feeling. You go to my head and you keep me happy, he says. And then Tina in her singing glory, you know, she says, ooh, oh, please. Or she says, ah, you know, ooh, baby, she says, ooh, baby. I can understand, she's saying to him, I'm saying to you, I can understand your worries and your problems trying to be a rising star. And if you're lonely, all you have to do, because you can be lonely in a relationship. You do know this, right? You don't have to be lonely in a relationship. Just be in a relationship where you're not lonely. And if you're lonely, she says, all you have to do is call my name out and I'll be there where you are. Just call my name out. She says, you belong to me. Lord knows I belong to you. See, put that thing together anyway, right? And we belong to each other, baby. Yes, you go to my head. I know I can't sing. It don't stop me from doing it because I like to. Baby, you're a part of everything I say and think and do. You go to my head. You're part of everything I say. I just on my mind constantly, right? You know the feeling. You know what it is. So you need to come figure that thing out. You know, you need to figure that out together with your person. I'm giving all my love to you. You go to my head and you make me happy. You keep me happy. Can I bring it down and talk to you a while? Can I talk to you? He says, woman, can I talk to you? You would say, you keep me happy. I think they're saying, you go to my head. They're saying, you keep me, the background saying, you keep me happy. Right under the stars aglow. He said, loving you and I, you keep me happy. Do you sing the rest of the lyrics over there? I'm singing, you keep me happy. Do you keep me happy. Oh, you keep me happy, right? So happiness is an inside job. You're responsible for your own happiness. And people can add to your happiness. And just because you say you're happy doesn't mean that you're saying that everything is perfect in your life, because it doesn't have to be perfect in order for you to have happiness, right? It is a mindset. It is a way that you think. It's the way that you operate. It becomes part of who you are, right? It becomes just what you exude. I exude this happy, right? People think, oh, everything must be so great with her. It's not great with me. I sit here all by myself waiting for my person to show up and it's miserable. But I still exude the happy because it's an inside job and it starts with me. So I won't let any one thing really tear me down, even though if it's hurtful, right? Hurtful things go on. And then you gain some resiliency and you bounce back. But it's still a heavy hurt piece all day, every day, all night, every night, right? When it's not together like it should be, right? So that's my thing. But I'm going to still choose to exude the happy when I need to, and even when I don't want to, because I know in the end, everything's going to work out. If God said it, I believe it, that settles it, right? So why should I worry about what it looks like right now? Because what it looks like right now is not what it really is. If you think about what's done in the spiritual realm is done first and then done in the natural realm. This is already done, this whole thing here, already done in the spiritual. You know it. I know it. It's already done. It's soon to be done in the natural, but we may not see that yet in the natural. But if you can do anything to spur that along, hey, by golly, why don't you? To lessen the feeling of misery and hurt and pain and longing and anguish and lack, right? That goes along with that, no communication and no connection, right? So no contact or whatever. So you have some power there to make something happen. Even if it's uncomfortable to do, but you know it's the right thing to do. You know it's what you really want. And you're finally, I believe, in your healing, you're finally tired of living for what other people want. And you're ready to live for what you want. And you better stand in that thing. Stand up in it. Yes, this is what I want. And this is what I'm going to go do. Because what do we always say in the community? Whose life is it? It's your life, by golly. So you got to go and do what you want, but it's going to take you to stand up in that thing, walk in that blessing. Yeah, God gave me this thing. I know these people don't like it. They don't have to like it. It's not their life. If they don't like what God gave me, that's on them. if they don't like what God gave them, that's on them. It's like you didn't like what God gave you at first. Then you realize, oh my gosh, that's what I really, really, really need. This is really exactly it. I wanted it, but I did not know how to describe it. I didn't even recognize it when I saw it, but then I did recognize it, but then I wasn't ready for it. But whatever it is, what's past is past. There's nothing you can do about what's already happened. When they say water under the bridge, right? Nothing you can do about that. But you can do everything about this moment and every moment forward. You have full control over what you do then, right? And you can cut the control off of people who have been puppeting you. They're not in charge of you. They're going to keep acting like they're in charge as long as you allow them to. And then when you tell them they're not in charge, they're still going to act like it because they peeped all your patterns. They know you so well. They know how to do the manipulation, and they're going to keep trying to pull you in the manipulation. Don't go back. Okay? Cut it, send them packing. They got to go. Your whole new life is waiting for you, right? And you keep me happy. So that's it. He's singing to her and she's singing to him and they're singing to each other. And we belong to each other, baby. Wow, you go to my head. You're a part of everything I say and think and do. I can't say, think, or do anything without you on my mind. What? I know it's the same for you, right? So what are you going to do about it, right? So let's listen. Last lesson. Again, he says, lady, I can understand your problems and your worries when you love a man like me. If you don't mind, I'll try to say I love you in this song now. Because if you don't know how to say it, sing it. or share the lyrics with the person. Say, this is exactly what I'm feeling. I don't know how to say it myself, but this describes it to a T. I'll try to say I love you in this song now. Listen to this melody. You belong to me and I belong to you. Yes, I do, he says. And we belong to each other, lady. Listen to me, baby, he says. There'll be times when I'll be down and I'll be troubled, and that's okay. Anyone who is your person, they're going to know that you'll be down in trouble. That's what they're there for, to help support you. And when they're down in trouble, you're there to support them. And we're not making each other happy. We are just extending the happiness. You're an extension of your person. They're an extension of you when you guys are in the right mindset and framework for it. Because if you're as happy internally and healing and or healed, and it's a healthy relationship, them being an extension of you or you being an extension of them is no harm, no foul. It just gets better and better, right? Because we're all in the right place, the right mindset, and we're healed or healing, right? But if we're staying in the toxic, we're staying in the low level thinking, we're staying in the kiddie pool way of relating to people, manipulating, tricking people, using people, whatever else people do when they're trying to take advantage of a situation or of a person, and being an extension of that is not good. And then being an extension of you is not good because it doesn't line up. But when you're both healed or healing, right? And you both have that internal happiness, right? And then when God ordained it and put it together, right? How could it go wrong? It can't go wrong, right? It cannot go wrong. It doesn't mean every day is a perfect day in the relationship, but it does mean that you know how to manage the talking through the difficult times. You know how to manage supporting each other when things are hard for one or the other. And when things are hard for both, you both know how to support each other through that and know that is just what's happening today. And maybe tomorrow and maybe for the next 3 months, that's what's happening. But it doesn't mean we're done. It means that we're going to work through this and everything's going to work out. Like God always works it out anyway. So, and that's in the healthy relationships, not just in any old relationship. Do not stay in a toxic situation just to say, oh, it's going to work out. You know, eventually, no. You do not stay in a toxic relationship. Whether they're toxic or you're toxic, clear. Let's be clear. You cannot be in that. But I'm talking about a healthy relationship, okay? Talk about a healthy relationship where you're healed or healing and close to healed, both of you, and you're both took responsibility for your own happiness. both trusting God for the outcome of the relationship and the destiny that he has on your lives. And then it's going to work out, right? And it's not like, oh, every day is bliss, even though it can be. We might hit a speed bump or a roadblock, or something could happen with a family member or with a friend or with the business or with job or with health or with anything. But we support each other through it. And that's the difference between healthy and unhealthy relationships, right? So Rick James and Tina Marie said, you keep me happy. So he said, there'll be times I'll be down and I'll be troubled trying to be that rising star, but don't worry. I'll never in our lifetime bust your bubble. Don't bust your woman's bubble or bring her down from where she is. You support her. That's what I tell my students. I teach public speaking class at college level public speaking courses. And I tell them, in this classroom, I'm going to ask you, what kind of audience are we? And you're going to say supportive. Why? Because we are a supportive audience for anyone who comes up here to speak. We're here in the learning environment. There's enough cackling and heckling out there in the real world. But as we're learning to become better speakers, better presenters, we need a supportive environment so that we can perfect our craft. And then we'll eventually deal with the people who want to, you know, throw tomatoes at you later. But here, because it's a learning environment, we're going to support each other. Same deal there. If things are going on, it's a healthy relationship, you support each other through it. You don't abandon them. Oh, they're acting, they're tripping, they're acting crazy. They're doing this and they're doing that. Not in an unhealthy relationship, but in a healthy one. You know, we're coming up on 2 years since I lost my precious, wonderful, beautiful Proverbs 31 mother, right? And I had my family to support me, but I didn't have a spouse. I didn't have a significant other. I'm just out here by myself. It would have been great to have someone support me through that huge loss, unexpected, huge, supersized loss. And I never knew how supersized a loss is of your mother until I lost my mother. I have friends who've lost their mothers, and I understand that it is a difficult thing. But when you lose your own mother, oh my gosh, it hits you like a whole ton of bricks, particularly if you had a very good relationship with your mom, which I did. And so, you know, I said in previous videos, I don't want to be in the front row at the funeral because that means I'm affected, immediate family affected in losing someone in this moment. My immediate family, we're in the front row. So it's, you know, my uncle, Bishop, his wife had already passed away, and Marianne. And then it's my aunt Sandra and her husband had already passed away. So their brother and sister, they could support each other. It's my dad and my mom is his spouse, and she just passed away, and it's her funeral. And then it's me, and I'm divorced. So I don't have any spouse. I don't have any person I'm seeing or anything. I'm just by myself, right? They're by themselves. I'm by myself. I shouldn't have to be by myself. I hoped I wouldn't have to be by myself in that time, but I was. So it's a tough piece. But when things like that happen, it's great when you have the relationship or particularly the marriage or whatever it is where you have a supportive spouse or partner, right? And so if you're going to be in a partnership, if you're going to be in a marriage, you got to be healthy or close to healed, and you have to know how and learn how maybe to support each other in these tough times. And the grief cycle, you know, it ebbs and flows. Some days it's okay. Most days it's crazy. And then some days it's okay. And then some days it's really okay. And then all of a sudden out of nowhere, it's awful. Right? And so we're coming up on 2 years and it's still awful some days. You know, I still want to pick up the phone and call. Oh, I got to tell mom this. I know she's watching and I could talk to her anytime, which I do, but I don't have anybody to bounce that whole thing off of, right? Siblings, yeah, but it's different to just have your own partner right there. So, you know, if you do have your spouse, significant other, and they go through a loss and they're dealing with grief, or you go through a loss, you're dealing with grief, you want someone there who is supportive, okay? And you know, the healthy, healing or healed people in relationships, the level of healed or healthy that you are, it changes the trajectory of how supported you feel in those grieving moments. I mean, because the grief is going to happen anyway. If I'm going to have a day that I got to lay in the bed, I'm going to have a day I got to lay in the bed. And it's great to have a supportive partner. If I had a supportive partner, it could help me get through it better. It doesn't mean that I'm not going to still feel that way, but I'm going to feel supported in it and not like I'm by myself, right? So if you do have someone and you're healthy, they're healthy, or you're healing close to healed, and you've learned how to support each other, thank God for that, right? Yeah, thank God for that. So, you know, I never would have thought I had to go through that by myself. You know, and I'm not by myself, but by myself, like without a partner, without a significant other in that way, you know? So nothing I can do about it. You know, when the time is right, the Lord will make it happen. So God will get my partner ready, willing and able when the time is right. Isaiah 60:22. But we're talking about happy. We're talking about happy. You belong to me. I belong to you. Yes, I do. But I was saying, I will never in our lifetime bust your bubble or bring you down from where you are. And he said, you're a queen to me. Whose woman doesn't want to hear that? You're a queen to me. And what woman doesn't want to know that their man realizes that they're a king and I'm a king to you? And we belong to each other, babe. Yeah, you go to my head. You're a part of everything I say and do. Everything I say and I do. Everything I think. Ugh, it's all day, every day. You go to my head. And you keep me happy. And then Tina comes in singing her beautiful melodious tones. Oh, baby, I can understand your worries and your problems. Because I'm a supportive spouse, supportive significant other. Trying to be a rising star. And if you're lonely, all you have to do is call my name out and I'll be there where you are. You belong to me, she says. Lord knows I belong to you. And we belong to each other, baby. Yeah, you go to my head. Baby, you're a part of everything I say and think and do. You go to my head and you keep me happy. Can I bring it down and talk to you? All right, let's play it. Let's see where it is. Can I talk to you, woman? Can I talk to you? I keep thinking it says, you go to my head. You keep me happy. So I looked up lyrics. I was like, I thought that said, you go to my head. It says, you keep me happy. Do, 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 do. All right, let's listen a little. Rick singing to Tina, then Tina singing to Rick. So you singing to me and me singing to you is how the scenario would go. Let's see if it plays. All right, all right. Happy with Rick James, Tina Marie.
Lady, I can understand your problems and your worries when you love a man like me. And if you don't mind, I will try to say I love you in this song now. Listen to this melody. You belong to me. I belong to you, yes I do, and we belong to each other, lady, listen to me, baby, there'll be times when I'll be down and I'll be troubled,
trying to be that rising star. But don't worry, I will never in our lifetime bust your bubble or bring it down from where you are. You're a queen to me. And Lord knows I'm a king to you, yeah.
There's Tina Marie. Tina Marie, you keep me happy. You keep me happy. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. We are sharing the love tonight. Sharing the love on How We Flow Out Today TV. It's Stephanie Stalwart, ATL Traffic Lady. Hey, hi, how are ya? I love all of that, all of that, all of that, all of that. We're sharing the love, boy. We ain't done this in a while. Singing that. We used to do some Friday night love songs, so decided to bring a little love back into it. Yeah, dig. So, hey, hi, how are you? What are you up to? What's going on? What you waiting for?